Let's briefly discuss the difference between ERC and EIP. So EIP stands for Ethereum Improvement Proposal. Anyone can create such a proposal. You just need to create a pull request on the GitHub repository at github.com/ethereum/EIPs. This can be anything you might think can improve the Ethereum network. For example, we previously mentioned the new gas cost mechanism, ERC-1559. This was such a proposal to change the mechanism so that miners won't receive all of the gas costs anymore. And then there are ERCs, which are a special type of EIP and stand for Ethereum Request for Comments. As a developer, you are more likely to deal with ERCs. They are standards on how to implement certain features. So, why do we need these standards? Imagine I create a smart contract that can manage its own currency. Those contracts are called tokens. I will define certain functions for how to read the balance and how to transfer the token. Now, an exchange wants to integrate and make use of my token. They will need to look at my contract and call the transfer function, exactly the way I intended it to be used. So they will need to create new software just to be able to use my one token. Now imagine they have to do this for thousands of types of tokens. Clearly, it's better if we can all agree on one standard only. And that's where the second part of the name Request for Comments, RFC, actually comes from, which were created as the first standards to be used in the beginning of the internet. Once an ERC is proposed, peer-reviewed, and finalized, it doesn't mean everyone will now start using them. There are many unused ERCs in existence. Only time can tell if a standard becomes really popular or not. Looking at the ERCs available in the Open Zeppelin contracts is a good first impression on what most people are using. But of course, there are more ERCs for all kinds of use cases. But the most popular of all ERCs is by far ERC-20. So let's look at that one in more detail.